in a previous video we looked at the overtones of the kalimba time, and we saw how the prominent overtone sounds at 2 octaves and a sixth. And we also saw that you can lower this overtone by thinning the tine or weighing it, or the easiest way, bending the tine at half of this free length. So a small bend takes the overtone down to 2 octaves and a fifth. And bending a little further, you get 2 octaves and a third. And next, we get the overtone at about a bend of 60 degrees. We get the overtone at 2 octaves. Kalimba with all the overtones tuned to 2 octaves. Plucking a thin wire tine is pretty hard on your fingers. If you do it a few times, it's okay, but not for a playable instrument. So one thing I tried is to make a sort of a curl at the tip of the tine, which is already easier on the fingers, but still has a relatively small area which you strike it. What worked better is to make a sort of semicircular tip of the tine, which provides a larger surface. And then you can bend this little tip depending on the angle of the tine. So we have a larger surface like this. So starting from the straight tine, we've been lowering the overtone. And if you you bend it further to about 90 degrees, you get the overtone at an octave and a fifth. So this is a chromatic kalimba with the overtones tuned to one octave and a fifth. Continuing to bend our tines further and further, we find the next overtone at octave and a third. It's not a natural harmonic, it's an interesting sound. And bending further, we get an overtone at one octave. Kalimba with overtones tuned to one octave. Sound. Thank you. not so easy to tune this one because you're tuning both the octaves and the fundamental tones at the same time, and I don't still have a strobe tune or anything. Bend the tines further, and after the octave, you'll get an overtone at the fifth of the fundamental. So, musically, maybe a little less useful, but an interesting sound nonetheless. Thank you.